Hello and welcome to this new workshop. In this workshop, we are going to make these lovely flowers. You can use as a coaster, but you can also use as decoration. You can make a little basket with your own knitted I-cord. See my I-cord video. Of course, you need a matching basket, but I did not have a basket at this moment that's matching. They are very easy and quick to make, so let's start. Knitting these flat circles is very fast and easy to do. You can even knit them in different colors on both sides. I knit them all the time with my scraps because I use them all the time at my workshops as a base. So when you do have some scraps, just knit these little flat circles and put them aside. When you find a workshop on my channel you like, you can start. I am going to knit it with my 22 needle eddy machine. I'm going to cast on. I assume you know how to use the machine. If you do not know how to use the machine, watch my video how to always knit perfect with your circular knitting machine. I'm casting on now. Casting on does not count as a row. I do not count, I do not use the counter. I eyeball it and we have to knit about 17 rows. The cast on does not count. 17 rows. When you knit a row less or more, that's not a problem. Just enjoy playing with your machine. I eyeball every time the needle comes by. So now I've knitted one round up to 17. So I finished my rounds. Now I'm going to measure my yarn. I put it around my machine one time. I cut it off. I take my yarn needle, take the yarn out of my feeder. A stitch less or more doesn't matter. Put the yarn into my needle. You know that you have to knit without your yarn in the feeder to release the stitches from the needles. So now we are going to pick up the stitches. I'm going to turn a little bit further. Be sure that the stitches are down because I don't want to hurt my hands by the wrong angle of my hand. We have to take care of our hands because we need them to craft. This is so easy. Normally I make a whole bunch with scrap yarns while watching Netflix. I don't knit them while watching Netflix. I am finishing them while watching Netflix. I just pulled the yarn and closed the hole. Be sure that each stitch is neat arranged. My yarn is coming out here. Now I just go to the other side of the little circle. Put my needle through. Let it come out on the opposite side. And then I always make a little loop. I put it around my needle. And when I pull it, it will be a little knot. Then I push through my needle. And it's secured. Then I take my needle and I just, where the yarn is coming out, I just put my needle in and take it to the inside. We let it hang, and then we take the other side and we are going to close that. Also, always close clockwise. See, now we have to arrange the stitches neat. This is the inside of my project. You can use it as the outside also, but now it's supposed to be on the inside. So I just roll it inside and then pull the yarn and be sure that the stitches are all neat arranged. Then this is the yarn that I pulled, because now there are two pieces of yarn coming out. This is the yarn from the other side, and this is the yarn that I pulled. And here I am going to close. This is the yarn from the other side. I'm doing the same, going from the opposite side to the side where my yarn comes out. I made that little knot, pull through, and now it's also secured. And now a little magic trick. I'm going to pull on the yarn from the other side, and then it will come to this side, and then I just simply knot those two tails on one side together. And put both tails into your yarn needle. Stick it inside somewhere next to where your knot is. Inside, not through both layers. And let it come out somewhere. And then you just simply cut them off and it's gone. Do not throw these away. Keep all those scraps, because you can knit a beautiful hat with your scraps. Throwing away is just a waste of good material. Knitting a hat is just as easy. You only have to knot a lot of tails, but you will not see that on the outside. So do not throw away pieces of yarn that are longer than 10 centimeters. So let's go to the project. To finish the flower, we need the flat circle, a pair of scissors, our yarn needle, and a crochet hook. Mine is 5.5 millimeters, but you can use whatever you like. It doesn't really matter. I make a slip knot. And now I'm going to explain what we are going to do. We have made our flat circle. We have 22 stitches in the round. This is a row of stitches. This is and this is. So we have 22 places where we can join our crochet hook with a slip stitch. You just go in between those two sides of a stitch, under two bars, get your slip stitch on your needle, pull through. Then make one chain and one single crochet under those same two bars. You can also crochet over your start tail. So in the same stitch, you make one single crochet. So we joined under those two bars, made one chain stitch, and we made a single crochet all in that first stitch. Then we are going to chain two. This one we skip. This one we are going to put our needle under two bars. Why two bars? One is not enough and it will make big loops. Just a little bit more firm. You make one single crochet and then two chains. Skip this, under those two bars, and under the starting tail, and knit one single crochet and every time you knit one single crochet and two chain stitches, skip one, under two bars, one single crochet and two chain stitches, skip one, underneath those two bars, one single crochet, two chain, and you are going to repeat that until you are all the way around. Be sure that you keep it a little bit flat. And you finish with two chains after the last single crochet. When you make a mistake, no problem. Nobody will notice the difference. When you're all the way around, push the pause button. And when you're all the way around, come back. When you have knitted your last two stitches, you just make a slip stitch under the first single crochet we made. Under two loops and just pull through. Then we are going to make a slip stitch in under that first chain space, a slip stitch in the first chain space, slip stitch, and then another single crochet in the same chain space. So we've closed with a slip stitch on the first single crochet, then we make a slip stitch in the first chain space, we did one chain and made a single crochet in the same first space. This is only the beginning of this round, for the rest it's going to be very easy. We are going to crochet in the next chain space 5 double crochets, USA terms double crochet. Yarn over, put your needle into the chain space, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through 2. Yarn over, pull through 2, and that you are going to do 5 times in the same chain space. Then, after doing 5 in one chain space, in the next chain space, you crochet 1 single crochet. In the next chain space, you crochet 5 double crochets. You are going to repeat this the whole round. So 5 double crochets in one chain, next chain 1 single crochet, next chain 5 double crochets, until you have done it all the way around. This you can do also in front of the TV. You can almost do it just on touch feeling. When you finished your last five double crochet, you just make a slip stitch on the first single crochet of your row and another chain. You cut off your yarn, pull through, take your yarn needle and just tuck the end in. Oh, so I just cut my finger. So I've got another one, and this is a base for a lot of fun things. If you like this video, give me a thumb up. If you want to see more of my free workshops, follow my channel. You can join it under this video. I'd like to see you another time. Have lots of fun with crafting.